Okay. When do we start? Are we going to clip, we're going to chop it up, so?
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay. Well, welcome to the first episode of Speaking Springfield. I am your host for the evening, Mayor Erica DuBois, and I'm very happy to have our first guest, our outgoing, although we don't want to allow him to be outgoing, Township Engineer, Mr. Sam Mardini. So welcome, Sam.
Thank you, Erica. Thank you.
We are glad to have you here, and I would like to just thank you for everything you've done for the community, and I wanted to just have people get a little bit more acquainted with you, even though you're not going to be with us much longer. What initially drew you to Springfield?
Originally, I was working for the Township of Warren as the engineering technician, and my responsibilities were limited. I was doing inspections for new development and assisting the township with the cover requirements even then. And I saw this advertisement for assistant township engineer, and when I read the description, talked about project management, assisting other department heads with infrastructure projects, and that really drew my attention, and I applied, and I went through two interviews, and I was hired.
Very nice. What about Springfield kept you here for more than two decades?
It's the diverse range of projects that I worked on. My job was really very diverse in that I worked on infrastructure projects for the township. I worked on the downtown redevelopment project. I started it a long time ago, and thank God we are now seeing, hopefully we'll see the fruit soon. We worked on the firehouse, the building of the new firehouse. We worked on the pool projects and the improvement to this building, the municipal building, and Chisholm Recreation Center, and many other large and small projects. So the diverse range of those projects really made my job a lot of fun.
Great. Talk about a memorable moment from your time here, something that really sticks out.
The biggest one that sticks out, believe it or not, are the hurricanes. When we started with Hurricane Floyd and back in 99, and then we had Hurricane Irene and then Sandy, the hurricanes were devastating, but the way that people came together during those hurricanes was outstanding. We had township staff that gave their free time and came to work, even though we had no power at each hurricane for 2 weeks. They gave their time to help the residents and the township, and they delivered food to people, and they served the communities and made robocalls to residents. It just was amazing. People in Springfield get together, you know, and help each other. And the other one was the pool project. That means a lot to me.
That's because I worked on it.
Yes, you did. And a lot of people doubted that we can do this project without closing the pool for a single season. And we were able to do that because we had a great township team, included some great professionals that helped us out.
Absolutely.
I was so confident because of my team and my colleagues that we will going to be able to do it, and we did it, and we did the project on time and within budget.
Yeah, you guys did a fantastic job. I mean, I know I got to be a part of that committee, but the day-to-day workings of that and the way you guys got it done on time was fantastic.
It really was.
And it was really a pleasure to work with you, and I learned so much.
Thank you.
Yeah. And I think the hurricanes might be part of this answer, but you mentioned those already, the biggest challenge at your time working here?
The biggest challenge was also related to hurricane, like you said. It's getting help for those people who live within the floodplain.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, if you live in a 100-year flood zone, you're going to flood if you have that kind of storm. However, we tried our best to do what we can to minimize the impact and to help the residents. And money is always a problem, because in order to really help those people, you have to elevate homes above the flood level. Sometimes you have to relocate people, and it's challenging because grants are limited for that kind of purpose. They give you a small amount, which is not enough, and you need to go in and clean the rivers and remove all the silt and provide more storage in those rivers, but the cost to remove that stuff and the permitting process and the cost to dispose of the material is so enormous that that became a burden for us.
Absolutely. And when, I think another part of that is when you put faces to the people who are dealing with that issue, it's much harder to have to deal with it knowing the cost restrictions and things
absolutely.
Like that.
Absolutely.
And finally, what will you miss most about working here in Springfield?
The mayor.
Of course.
I will certainly miss my staff. I have wonderful staff and my colleagues. I have great friends. And I will miss working with many residents. In the past 26 years, I have met so many of Springfield residents, and I helped them out, and some helped me. I made a lot of friends, and I will definitely miss all of these people.
I would like to add that you have become, prior to me even being where I am or sitting up here in any capacity, such a part of the fabric of Springfield that I think most people probably assume you live here. You probably spend more time here than you do in your hometown. And we are just grateful for everything you've done for Springfield, and I'm really appreciative that you took some time today to just share your closing thoughts with us, and good luck in your future endeavors. And you'll be missed, but thank goodness I have your cell phone number, so I will not be forgotten.
Thank you, and I want to thank all the Springfield residents who gave me that opportunity to serve them, and I appreciate it, and thank you for your friendship. And I want to thank the Township Committee, current and previous committees, for all the support they have given me and our staff.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Ahem.